Hi viewer, I welcome you to Adim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Mathematics Form 3, lesson number 21. The topic it is Commercial Arithmetic 2. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mugem. Let us look at the lesson goals. We are going to review whatever we did in Commercial Arithmetic 1. Then we go to Simple Interest. Now, when we talk about Commercial Arithmetic 1, we dealt with the profit. We also dealt with the losses. We also dealt with the discount, commission, of that. And now we want to go to deep details where now we start going to the bank. Looking at the advancing of the loan. We start by the simple interest. But before we go to the simple interest itself calculation, there are some terms that you need to know. One, it is the interest. When we talk about the interest, it is that money that is charged for the use of borrowed money for a specific period of time. You go and get a loan from any financial institution. There is that excess amount of money that you pay from whatever you have borrowed. That is what we refer to it as interest. Then we have the principal. It is the sum of money that you borrowed or deposited in order for you now to get the interest. Then we have the rate of interest. This is the ratio of interest earned in a given period of time to the principal. Then we have the simple interest. It is calculated using only the initial, that is the principal, at a given rate and time. That is the reason why we get the formula as that. Formula for calculating the simple interest. Interest is equal to the rate times principal times time divided by 100. Where does 100 come from? 100 comes from the rate. Rate is given in percentage. Then we also have another term, that is the amount. It is the sum of money at the end of a given period of time. This includes both the principal plus the interest. That is when now we get the amount. You can be able to see how we get the simple interest. It is the principal times rate times 100 times time. So interest earned after 2 years, money borrowed or invested, rate, it is annual rate of interest, and T, the length of the time you borrowed or invested. We start by looking at the examples. Example, find the simple interest that would accrue when a welfare group lends to a member 15,000 at a rate of 12% in 1 year. Remember, the formula is supposed to be principal times rate times time divided by 100. We analyzed, we put our statement into mathematics. Principal, it is 15,000, rate, it is 12, time, it is 1. So in that case, you replace the values. So it is 15,000 times 12 times 1 divided by 100, which is 1,800. That is the simple interest. We go to the example, the next one. Mr. Karaoke borrowed 560,000 from a bank to buy a vehicle. He is required to repay the loan with simple interest for a period of 48 months. The repayment amounted to 21,000 per month. Calculate the amount of interest paid to the bank. Number two, the rate per annum of the simple interest. So we go to the using the formula, which is that principal is 560,000 times 48 divided by 2. Amount paid, it's supposed to be 48 times 21,000, which is given as 1,008,000. So what, how do I get the simple interest? It's supposed to be the amount minus the principal. So we get, after doing that, the answer we get is supposed to be 448,000. That is taking the 1,008,000 minus 560,000. It is giving us 448,000. Part B, the rate per annum of the simple interest, supposed to be the interest. We use now the formula. My principal, it is 560,000. My rate, we don't know, times the 4. That is the 4 months, then divided by 100. How do I get 4? It is 48 divided by 12, the time. So in that case, you get it is 20%, and that becomes the rate per annum. Example 3. Juma invested a certain amount of money in the bank, which paid 12% per annum. Simple interest. After 5 years, his total savings were 5,600. Determine the amount of money he invested. So we use the formula. Now we don't know the principal. So it's supposed to be the amount minus the interest. So in that case, now you happen to have 5,600 minus principal times 12 times 5 divided by 100. We take the 100 to the other side. So in that case, you happen to have that. So when we multiply by 100 everywhere, we are getting 100 P is equals to 560,000 minus 60 P. So in that case, we bring the right terms together. We get 140 P is equals to 560,000. So when we divide, we get the principal being 4,000. That is how we get the principal from whatever we have. Calculate the amount invested at a rate of 12% per annum for a period of 4 years for it to accrue to 26,640. Using the formula, you can be able to get, supposed to be the interest is supposed to be principal times rate divided by 1,000. My total amount is supposed to be 26,640 minus P. Is equals to the principal times 4 times 12 divided by 100. So we solve the equation. We bring 100, or we take 100 to the other side, which is giving me 100 times 26,640 minus 100 P is equals to 48. So in that case, you are getting 266,400,000 is equals to 48 plus 100 P. So in that case, you get P is equals to 18,000. So that is how we get the principal in that case. For reference, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Mathematics Student Book 3, that edition. You can contact us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And also, you can get us from the Twitter. Stay tuned to Edim TV. Thank you.